You've had your salary negotiation, got all the way through, and now it's time to wrap it up. Here's a couple tips on how you can wrap up your salary negotiation very effectively, whether you get a yes or a no. First of all, if you get a yes in the salary negotiation, thank the person for their willingness to negotiate, not for the raise, because you've either earned it, or in the case of a situation where you're new to the company, you're bringing that value. But do thank them for their openness to negotiate and use that moment to reiterate your commitment to them and the company. When you get a no, it's a little more tricky because we're typically not feeling our best at the moment that we hear the no. So be ready for that and have a plan in place so that you can confidently close that conversation. I'm going to focus on what to do if you're in your current company with your current leader. So ask that person to give you some feedback on what you need to do in order to move ahead in your career, and use this opportunity to draft a plan jointly that you will execute and that leader will support. It could be in terms of providing a training, so there could be a monetary level of support, or it could be asking if you can shadow in another department, if they'd help you find a mentor. There's all different things that your leader can do to support you. And then create a reoccurring meeting with them if you don't already have one, at least every other week. If you have regular one-on-ones once a week, that's great, but if you don't, try to get on their calendar every 2 weeks. If they really push back on that, at least once a month to talk about the progress that you're making, the advice that you took seriously, and what you're seeing in terms of added results. And then also ask them when they would be willing to have another salary discussion. It might be in 6 months, it might be in a year. And walk away and make that appointment immediately so that both you and your boss know that you're serious, that you're going to close the gaps, and that you want to have that conversation again in 6 months or a year, whenever the two of you decide is the right time to continue that discussion. Hearing a no never feels good. Walk away and really listen to the advice. Take out those pieces that you can take action on that are going to make you more influential and promotable in your career, and use that to move you forward. Sometimes a no is the best thing you can hear because you're really going to learn what it takes in that organization to rise in your career, and the way you handle it will show your maturity and create a bond with your leader that you just don't get when you get the yes. So don't look at it as a step back. Look at it as a way to craft a plan that's going to move you forward, and be ready to close your compensation negotiation discussion strongly, whether you get a yes or you get a no.